What's going on, guys? It's Luke22SV here, back with the final round of the Mick Schumacher career mode here for the Abu Dhabi Grand Prix. After just two seasons, we're going to be ending it, going on to F1 2019. We just didn't have enough time to make a season three, and 2019 is going to be my main focus as well. And we're going to have some videos uploaded in between now and then as well. So off the back of a win in Brazil and sealing the title in Brazil, more importantly, we now have the pressure off of us coming into this weekend, and we can really focus and have some freedom as well around this track. Not one of my favourite tracks though, so we'll see how it goes as we come onto our qualifying run, our first run, and this is one of my least favourite tracks on the calendar, probably one of the most disliked tracks on the calendar actually. Come around the first corner and we come up towards the this is basically just the first sector. We come around the next left-hander and we go over this curb, and now we run a bit wide and over the curbs and into the wall, and that's going to be our qualifying over straight away. So our final qualifying in the Mick Schumacher career mode is ended with an incident into the wall, and you're about to see again the replay of what happened. We just ran out wide onto those curbs. We bounced over. You can see it from this view. You just see how badly we bounced over those curbs, and we were out of the control end. We were just a passenger, really. And here's the slow-mo as well. So we're just out running out wide. We just reduced the steering lock as well, so that didn't really help us. And then we had to oversteer and just correct it. But at this point, we were a passenger, and we're just heading straight for that wall. And we're just hoping to slow the cars down as much as possible. Our brakes have locked, and we hit the wall, and that's going to be the end of our session. There's a slow impact in the end, but it was enough to knock off the front right wheel, and that's going to be a disappointing way to end our qualifying season. And we're going to be starting from the back of the grid then, so it could be an exciting race then, starting from the back of the grid. Unless there's penalties, we may move up, but we'll see how it pans out. And it's going to be a wet race as well in Abu Dhabi. Very rare to see rain in Abu Dhabi. So we've got rain in Abu Dhabi for the final race of this career mode then. It should be interesting to see how the season ends. Of course, you've got to love a bit of rain. We haven't had too many wet races this season as well, so this could throw a surprise result perhaps if things go crazy. But I will see how the final grid for this career mode is. And it's Leclerc on pole, who's been on form in the second half of the season, Verstappen, and the two Germans of Vettel and Hülkenberg have been in very solid form in the second half of the season as well. Raikkonen, Hamilton, Sainz, Bottas, and the Force Indians have been very strong as well. Ricciardo, who's fallen away in the second half of the season, and then you've got the two Hasses and the two Toro Rossos, and Williams and Van Dorn have been terrible all career mode really. We go on to the start then, the final race of this Mick Schumacher career mode for the Abu Dhabi Grand Prix, as we come onto those five red lights for the final time, and we're about to see whether we can get a good start or not. And it's lights out, and the way we go for one last time in this Mick Schumacher career mode. It's a fairly sluggish start as well, but can we get a dive bomb into turn one? And yeah, that's exactly what we're going to do. We dive bomb past six drivers, and then we make it a seventh as Magnussen decides to get out of the way for us. How kindly of him after doing nothing in season one. And then you can see Ocon's holding up Alonso and Ricciardo, and we take the perfect opportunity to swing around the outside of Ricciardo and almost Alonso, but we run out of room. Now we dive down the inside of Alonso into the chicane, and we can almost get past him into the exit of that chicane. We are now into P11, and think about going straight up in the inside of Ocon, taking P10 away from him. And now our next target is Sergio Perez. So a great start to this Abu Dhabi Grand Prix. We're up into P10, and now we can focus on catching up to Sergio Perez and see if we've got the pace to keep up with these guys, because we know in these wet conditions the AI can sometimes be really strong. And Ocon, is he fighting back down the straight? And one of the main overtaking opportunities on this track, followed by the one shortly afterwards, where is also an overtaking opportunity here. So can we make an overtaking opportunity on Sergio Perez perhaps? We'll see if we can get a tow here. There's no good, there's going to be no DRS whilst the rain's coming down. So we have to take our opportunities. We dive down the inside of Sergio Perez, and we take the move, and we go up to P9. So a Daniel Ricciardo style move on Sergio Perez moves us up to P9. So we gain 11 places on lap one. Remarkable start to this race. So a great way to end the season then, hopefully. And now we just got to focus on seeing if we can catch up to Valtteri Bottas and the rest of the pack in front of us. But these conditions are very tricky, and you can see how much we're struggling to actually get the car through the corners. Again, oversteering. We're doing more oversteering than we are actually steering at the moment. And we're just going to come around to the end, the first lap of this race then. You can see Valtteri Bottas ahead of us. And then you can see The looks like the Mercedes of Hamilton as well, and Carlos Sainz as well, ahead of Bottas. There's the end lap one, then in P9, gaining 11 places after the first lap. And now we can see the replay of the start and see how we made up these positions. You can see Leclerc in first and then Verstappen in second. And you can see everyone else doing their train tracky route into turn one. It's one thing I really hate about this game, and I'll be glad, hopefully, that's not in F1 2019. And we just dive down the inside of all those cars into turn one, and Magnussen just happily gets out of the way for us, which is something he's never done in this career mode. And then you can see Ocon was holding up Alonso and Ricciardo. We took the opportunity to get past Ricciardo again. We ran out of road, and you can see Alonso, and now we just dive past him again. Again, everyone's train tracking still. It's just a really boring sort of lap one they have on here. Again, so easy to make up positions. If the F1 games were realistic, we may have gained like one or two positions at best. But of course, there's no incidents as well. The AI really need improving, really. They've come a long way still, but they haven't really been good since F1 2012. And in terms of actually not being on rails, because on 2012, they went in conditions like this, you could often see cars spinning. But even when the conditions are so tricky, in the wet and the like dry to wet conditions, the AI just on rails, and it's just quite boring, really. And they need to change that eventually for 2019 or 2020 if they haven't done that for 2019. But there, you can see we dive down the inside of Sergio Perez and take the position away from him, and now we're up into P9 and they're knocking over the bollard as well. Now we move on to lap two, and you can just see how much we're struggling in these conditions. And see Sergio Perez is now still behind us, and we're struggling to catch up with Valtteri Bottas ahead of us, Carlos Sainz as well. So it looks like we're going to have to just settle in for this race now and see if the conditions can change or not. They don't even look that wet, and again we're oversteering at every point, and it was just really frustrating for us. And now we've got to come down this straight with Sergio Perez still in our mirrors, still that proximity arrow looms behind us. And you can see we get set a purple sector too, but I think that's just everyone's, it's just the second lap. So now we can see this is a part of the track where we actually are fast as well. So you can see we actually close in a bit on Valtteri Bottas through this little part of the track. And well, now we just got to see whether we can actually maintain the gap to Valtteri Bottas to close in, because we're really struggling in these kind of conditions where it's just very shallow sort of conditions where you don't really know whether it's dry or wet, or wet or inters. And now we're just really sort of struggling. But coming towards the end of this lap, we're actually looking okay. But again, just one little mistake, and everyone, the AI just on rails, so they're not going to make any mistakes. So you just literally have to drive perfectly to actually be able to keep up with these guys, which is just so frustrating. You can see Leclerc going as fast as well. But now we're moving on to lap four, and again, we haven't been able to make any progress. We're sort of holding up Sergio Perez. We go to...
The weather is going to dry up in about 5 minutes.
Well, yeah,
certain which is the best tyre right now, dries or winters?
Well, there you go. Dries or inters, they're not certain which tyres are best. So we started this race on intermediates, and they're not. It's been raining the same sort of length, same sort of humidity as well, and same sort of duration. The rain's not really changed since the start of the race, so perhaps this race is just sort of, the rain is just, the weather is just not really changed, so perhaps the tyres can still be... we can actually switch to these soft tyres, the hyper soft tyres, and then we can see how we do. And well, now we're moving on to lap five, and we decide to switch onto the hyper soft tyres. And now we're just being the first ones to switch over these tyres as well. And hopefully this can actually move us up the order a bit. Have we got this decision right, or are the engineer going to be eating his words? Because he said that he's not sure which tyres are the best ones, so we've got to take a risk, because these intermediates really aren't working. And now we can see whether these hypersofts are going to work for us. We come out the pits and see how this outlap goes then. And now we've just got to make sure that we can not run into the pit wall as well. It's a very difficult pit lane, actually. If you brake a little bit too late, you're going to look very embarrassed as you come out the pits. And we actually come out the pits not in stone dead last, and we're actually ahead of Stoffel Van Dorn. So this could be a good sort of like viewpoint to see whether these soft tyres are going to, or these dry tyres are going to actually be quicker than the inters. And good way to compare. Again, we're oversteering still, but it is slightly raining. We don't know whether these tyres are actually good enough yet. They're still a bit cold, but just need to get a little bit of temperature into these tyres. I'm going to go as fast as possible on this outlap and see whether we can actually make any headway on the guys ahead of us, because we were holding up the guys behind us at the moment, like Sergio Perez and everyone like that, and now we've got to come to this chicane. If we brake late, we're just going to skate off the road. We seem to have got it right, and we've still got Stoffel van Dorn just behind us, but now can we start to pull away from him? And the rain should be stopping anytime soon, so we should see a dry line coming soon. And he's telling us to cool down our tyres, but I'm not sure if he realises we put on the dry tyres yet. So we'll come now and we'll just see if we've actually pulled away a little bit from Stoffel van Dorn. So are these dry tyres working? It looks interesting. And you can actually see on the minimap there's a few cars coming into the pit. So it looks like they're starting to switch over to the dry tyres as well. And now we can see whether this is going to work for us as we break down. And this is one of the difficult corners as well. On these dry tyres, we don't know what the conditions are going to be like, whether we're going to end up just skating off the road if we brake a little bit later. And then we're just going to have to watch the braking points as well, because the track is starting to dry, so we don't know. We have to test the braking and the track limits every lap just to see if we've pushing it to the limit. But of course, the AI are going to get it perfect every time, because they are just on rails, as I've said before. But now we're going to come around and see if we've actually made an undercut. You can see Sergio Perez is actually underneath us, and Raikkonen's just ahead of us as well. So it looks like this has actually worked a little bit for us, and we're actually out of shape. Oh no, because Sergio Perez has actually got out in front of us, so it hasn't completely worked. In fact, Perez has managed to overcut us actually, and we looked to dive down the inside, and that was probably a move we shouldn't have made, because now Perez has made a little bit of contact and lucky to not come away with front wing damage there. Now we've got DRS that's been enabled now, and now we can see whether we can get past Sergio Perez on the back straight with DRS open for the first time. And then we're going to get it open now. Are we too far back, or can we get a nice toe? And it looks like we're getting closer to Sergio Perez to perhaps think about an overtake here. We dive down the inside. Oh no, he's broken a little bit later. We broke a little bit earlier, and just testing the limits still. We've still despite breaking earlier, we almost went off the road. And again, Perez cuts back underneath us and retakes 13th place. And now we've got DRS again, and we're going to take it 13th place back from him. So we've managed to get back ahead of Sergio Perez. So we've managed to stay ahead of him for now, but this wasn't really what we wanted to have picking early. So actually, we wanted to be actually catching up with the guys ahead of us. And it looks like we caught up with Raikkonen. He's had a bit of a bad pit stop by the looks of it. He's probably been held up by cars coming in because he's a bit earlier down the pit lane. So now we can see whether he's on this dry track, whether we can actually catch up to the guys in front, or whether we're just going to fall back and just settle again for 9th place by the looks of it. But everyone else is now pitting again, so we've got to see whether we can actually close in on these guys and whether we can actually gain any positions from this pit stop. And hopefully it's going to work out for us in this final race of the Mick Schumacher career mode. We're hoping for a good race, and it would be awesome to see whether we can actually do well. And we actually set the fastest lap of the race there, because we're the first one to switch over to these dry tyres. And now everyone's coming out of the pits, and it looks like we're going to stay in P9. And indeed, we do stay in P9. We're going to move on to lap 10 then. We're still in P9, and we're still only a second ahead of Sergio Perez, not making any headway on the guys ahead of us. So now we're just going to come around again, and this is a place where we oversteer and we're off the track, and we just got to come back on the track, and we just knocked the polystyrene double walled out. And now Perez is overtaking us, but we look to dive down the inside, and that's a terrible decision from us. We've run into the back of Sergio Perez, we lost a bit of front wing, we're in a spin, and now Brendan Hartley's come through, and he's taken off another part of our front wing. So now Hartley's ruined this for us as well. We dive down the inside of Hartley again, lose the rest of our front wing. It's all unfolded for us in the just the last few corners. And what on earth has just happened there? A complete mishap in our last race of this Mick Schumacher career mode. And now we're just going to have a look at this replay. We just oversteer there, and then we run off the track, and we just come back on the track here. Perez has got past us, and we see Perez overtaking us. We just think, oh, we've got to get back past him. And it was a wrong decision, a rush of blood to the head, lose our front wing, we turn the car around, get a bit more oversteer, and Brendan Hartley just runs into us. Perhaps he didn't see us, or perhaps I was in the way of him, I don't really know, but we decided to try and get past him, and then getting a revenge, and we just lost a bit of front wing, lost the rest of our front wing, and now we're going to have to pit, and this is not the way we wanted to end a Mick Schumacher career mode. We've come into the pits now, we're in P17. And it looks like we're going to fall to the back of the order. Stoffel van Dorn's going to get past us as well. And we're going to be in P19 by the looks of it. because I think one of the Williamses is very far down the order, as you'd expect. It's Lance Stroll. But now we're going to get that front wing on, and then we can see what kind of lap time. So hopefully going to post the fastest lap time in the race. We'll come out in P19, and this is a disappointing way to end the Mick Schumacher career mode, but what can you do? These things happen, and we'll look forward to the F1 2019 career mode. But first, we got just four laps to go then, and we can see whether we can set the fastest lap of the race then, and we're going to follow us onto lap 13 in just a moment's time. We come out of the pits, and now a disappointing way to end the season, but we've won a championship, so there was nothing to play for coming into this round. And hopefully we can just see ourselves go on to lap 13 now. We set the fastest lap on lap 12, but this is going to be the fastest lap of the race, hopefully. And we come around the first corner. And now we're coming towards this lap. And it's one of my least favourite tracks, but we're on the freshest start. We're on the freshest tyres on the track, so we should be setting the fastest lap of the race. We're on the best track conditions as well that they have been so far. And straight away going purple in sector one. We haven't got the most ERS either, so we might be a bit slower down the straight. So we might not set the fastest sector two, but that should be irrelevant. The track conditions have been the best as they have all race. But Leclerc still leading the race as well. So if we didn't seal the title in Brazil, we would be screwed coming into this race after the way things have happened in this race. We got a 27-point gap. It's going to go down to two as things stand. So Leclerc's had bulletproof reliability. He hasn't had to take any grid penalties like we anticipated. So coming into this last race in the unknown, we actually thought that Leclerc was going to take a grid penalty, but we take purple sector two as we come round to sector three then of this track. It's probably my favourite part of this track, the only part of the track that I actually enjoy too much. This is a difficult part. Sometimes you just oversteer coming into here, and it's very easy to get out of shape in the braking zone as well. And now we come into this part, and we see we're actually closing up on Stoffel Vandoorne, who's had a terrible race yet again. And he was a driver that caused us problems in Spa of season one when he tried to come into the pits, and we were trying to get past him on the outside. Can we catch up to Stoffel Vandoorne on the last lap of the race? And we're going to cross the line to set the fastest lap of the race, hopefully. And it's definitely going to be the fastest lap of the race. And it's the final lap of the race then, and we've set the fastest lap of the race in our final race of this Mick Schumacher career mode. And now we've just got to focus on the last lap of the race, because Leclerc is going to come around the final lap to win the race as well. By looks of it, he's first on the mini-map, as you can see, down in the bottom left-hand corner. And then Max Verstappen is second. It looks like one of the Mercedes is third. And now we can see Stoffel Vandoorne in our sights as well. So, as we're on the final lap of the race, I'd just like to say that thank you, everyone, for tuning in to the Mick Schumacher career mode. Obviously, I've made a few mistakes here. I've only just started with the commentary, and obviously I'm not going to be perfect, but I'm going to try and keep improving. As things stand, this is just basically a test run for F1 2019. Of course, if you've been watching through this video, you've noticed that I have probably started a few times, and I'm going to try and work on everything and try and improve the commentary over time, but of course it's not going to be perfect for the time being, and we're just going to make sure that I keep improving and working on ways that I can improve and hopefully deliver a perfect F1 2019 career mode. And I would like to thank everyone and my 1,000 subscribers that I've just hit now. A few days ago I hit 1,000 subscribers, so thank you so much for that. Now I just want to keep growing as well. That'd be awesome to see, and hopefully I can produce some good content as well in between now and then. And I'll be delighted to hopefully have a good amount of videos on F1 2019 hopefully as well. But now we come round the final corner of this lap and the final corner of the career mode, and we're going to take home, and we're actually celebrating the P19. I don't think I've ever seen anyone celebrate coming in 19th, unless they were driving a HRT. But yeah, that's going to be the end. That's the final race of this career mode then. We actually finished the Abu Dhabi Grand Prix as we did last season, pretty much. We had a terrible race in Abu Dhabi last season. But again, Abu Dhabi, one of my weakest tracks. And Frédéric Vasseur winning yet another race. He's going to be delighted with that. As we end the race then, you can see Leclerc, a bit of a hollow victory for him, finishing second in the championship, 2 points behind me in the end, and Max Verstappen finishing second in the race, and not sure who finished third, but it ended up, it looks like Verstappen finished third in the end. So Vettel was second, so Vettel was the informant at the end of the season, and there you go. At the end of the race, then the end of the career mode. So let's see the final standings for the final time. And you can see the final results of the final top 10. And Ricciardo managed to get into the top 10 in the end. And Hamilton finished the season overtaking Hülkenberg for P6. He had a good season and a struggling Mercedes team. And they've gone off the boil since season 1 after the regulation changes. And then you can see we won the championship in the constructors by some margin in the end. Ferrari finishing 3rd, Renault 4th, Mercedes in 5th, Force India. Then you can see McLaren and Williams having a terrible season, and they both finished 9th and 10th. But that's going to be the end of that, and the end of the career mode as we move on to the final thing. Then, as you can see, nice job this season. We did perform well. We get the same kind of cutscene as we did last season, for goodness sake. I mean, we won the championship, and you just said, can't at least show a bit more emotion than that. I mean, come on, unless you're having an affair with Charles Leclerc, then I understand, but...
This isn't bumper cars at the fair.
Yeah, we'll move on to the end of the season then.
Pay more attention.
She's just having a go at us now, so yeah, that's as you'd expect. But now we're going to start a contract negotiation as if we were going into season 3. But this is what we would be doing, and what I'm sure would happen in real life had we won the championship with Sauber. We'd definitely move the Ferrari, as would Mick Schumacher, and that's what we're just basically following. He wants to follow in his father's footsteps, of course, who went on to win several championships with Ferrari. And of course, I think that would be awesome to see Mick Schumacher replicate his father's success one day. And that's what we would be hoping to do if we did a third season. It would be interesting to see how the third season would go, but hopefully there'll be interesting to see how the career mode will go on F1 2019 and see what kind of thing we do then. But there you go. And we have joined Scuderia Ferrari then, as we would move on to season 3 with the rule changes as well. So who knows how that would go. But that is going to be the end of the career mode there. As you can see, our results from Australia, we finished 4th, 7th, 3rd, 2nd in Azerbaijan. And then we had a good run from Spain all the way to Italy, really, where we just finished so strong. We didn't finish outside the top 5. And then we had a DNF in Singapore and a couple of DNFs towards the end of the season, actually. That DNF in USA was a real... really hurt us, to be honest. It could have dented our championship hopes. But that's going to be the end of the career mode then, and the end of the season 2 of Mick Schumacher career mode. And we'll see you soon for some more videos. I got a good idea of things I'm going to upload soon. And hopefully we can see you again for some more career mode in F1 2019. Thank you for everyone that's watched through from the beginning, and those that have joined in halfway through. And thank you for all again for the 1,000 subscribers. It means a lot. And I'll see you very soon for some videos. Like and subscribe and comment. I'll thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you guys soon.